गुड मॉर्निंग, नमस्ते भाइयों बहनों, ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, डॉक्टर्स, मिनिस्टर्स, रेस्पेक्टेड पर्सन्स, द मोस्ट वेनरेबल ऑफिशियल्स, कोलीग्स, वर्कर्स, डॉक्टर्स, मिनिस्टर्स एंड द पर्सन्स दोज हू आर लिसनिंग फ्रॉम द फील्ड ऑफ साइंस, रिलीजन, इंजीनियरिंग, आर्ट, कॉमर्स. आई डॉक्टर राकेश फ्रॉम USA वेलकम ऑल. नाउ टुडे एंड हियर वी विल लर्न हाउ टू केयर न्यू बॉर्न बेबी, अबाउट हिज क्लॉदिंग. Infants need to be warm and comfortable. What babies wear depends on the weather. If parents are wearing light clothing, then baby can wear light clothing too. Babies should not be overdressed since this can cause them to be hot and irritable. About hygiene, diapers should be changed frequently. Not changing diapers when wet or dirty can lead to discomfort and skin irritation. Cloth diapers are better than plastic ones, and diapers should be free of chemicals and fragrance. If your baby gets a rash on his bottom, leave the diaper off for as long as possible to air the skin. Bathing. Infants need to be clean. Babies should be bathed with a sponge until the umbilical cord falls off about 10 to 14 days. The umbilical cord should be cleaned every 4 to 6 hours with surgical spirit or a type of medical alcohol. After the cord falls off, babies can be bathed in a tub with mild non-detergent baby soap. Water should be warm, never hot. Test the temperature before putting your baby in the water. After bathing, oils and powders are not necessary. However, if dry skin develops, you can use a cream or lotion. If your baby develops cradle cap, yellow scales on the head, put almond or coconut oil on their head once a day until the scales go away. About sleeping, infants need sleep. Babies sleep many hours throughout the day, and sleep patterns differ from one baby to the next. During the first few weeks, babies should sleep in the parents' room. Babies should be placed on their back to sleep. Sleeping on the stomach or side has been related to cot death or SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome. So, sleeping on their stomach or side has been related to cot death or SIDS. Babies should be placed on their back to sleep. Babies should not get too hot. Babies should not get too hot when sleeping or at any other time. This can raise the chance of death. Babies cannot sweat, so you can feel their heads to see if they are hot or look to see if they are not comfortable. Loving and comforting. Infants need stimulation. Babies enjoy it when you talk to or sing to them. They also love to be held and cuddled. A daily massage with baby oil or coconut oil is nice for baby and for you. Infants cry. Crying is how babies talk to their parents. Some babies cry more than others. Babies cry when they are hungry, uncomfortable, lonely, sick, angry, in pain, or have a wet diaper. Some infants are colicky. Young babies who are during most of their waking hours are called colicky. Colic is stomach pain caused by gas and usually disappears after a few months. If your baby has colic, you can try holding the baby more often at times when he or she is not crying, gently rubbing the abdomen or stomach area, burping the baby more often during feedings, changing the diet, avoiding cow milk formula, gently rocking the baby in one's arm or in a cradle. Infants must have regular medical visits. A doctor or health worker can watch your baby's growth and development. They will also check for common childhood illness and give immunizations. So these are about to care newborn baby. Next we are reading about importance of attitude. Attitude and gratitude, there are two words in English we study. These are very important to learn for every successful person or for beginning the success. Thanksgiving is the way of attitude to gratitude. Thanksgiving is the way of gratitude to attitude. So there is a story behind it. There was a man who made a living selling balloons at a fair. He had all colors of balloons, including red, yellow, blue, and green. Whenever business was slow, he would release a helium-filled balloon into the air, and when the children saw it go up, they all wanted to buy one. They would come up to him, buy a balloon, and his sales would go up to again. He continued this process all day. One day he felt someone tugging at his jacket. He turned around and saw a little boy who asked, "If you release a black balloon, would that also fly?" Moved by the boy's concern, the man replied with empathy, "Son, it is not the color of the balloon, it is what is inside that makes it go up." The same thing applies to our lives. It is what is inside that counts. The thing inside of us that makes us go up is our attitude. Have you ever wondered why some individuals, organizations, or countries are more successful than others? It is not a secret. These people simply think and act more effectively. They have learned how to do so by investing in the most valuable asset, people. I believe that the success of an individual, organization, or country depends on the quality of their people. I have spoken to executives in major corporations all over the world and asked one question. If you had a magic wand and there was one thing you would want changed that would give you a cutting edge in the marketplace, resulting in increased productivity and profits, what would that be? The answer was unanimous. They all said that if people had better attitudes, they would be better team players, and I would cut down waste, improve loyalty, and in general, make their company a great place to work. William James of Harvard University said, "The greatest discovery of my generation is that human beings can alter their lives by altering their attitudes of mind." Experience has shown that Human resources is the most valuable asset of any business. It is more valuable than capital or equipment. Unfortunately, it is also the most wasted. People can be your biggest asset or your biggest liability. Through TQP, Total Quality People. Having been exposed to a number of training programs, as such customer service, selling skills, and strategic plannings, I have come to the conclusion that all these are great programs with one major challenge. None of them works unless they have the right foundation. And the right foundation is TQP. What is TQP? TQP is Total Quality People. People with character, integrity, good values, and a positive attitude. Don't get me wrong, you do need all the other programs, but they will only work when you have the right foundation, and the foundation is TQP. For example, some customer service programs teach participants to say please and thank you, give smiles and handshakes. But how long can a person keep on a fake smile if he does not have the desire to serve? Besides, people can see through him, and if the smile is not sincere, it is irritating. My point is, there has to be substance over form, not form over substance. Without a doubt, one does need to remember please and thank you. The smiles, etc., they are very important, but keep in mind that they come a lot easier when accompanied by a desire to serve. Someone once approached Blaise Pascal, the famous French philosopher, and said, "If I had young brains, I would be a better person." Pascal replied, "Be a better person and you will have my brains." The Calgary Tower stands at 190.8 meters. The total weight of tower is 10,884 tons, of which 6,349 tons is below ground.